Hey guys, Miss Mosh here. Sorry, I was setting up my stream. Here is part two of Bastion. I'm going to be picking up exactly where we left off with the last stream slash recording of this. I'm really excited. Like I said yesterday, or when I made the first video, which was yesterday, but I really love this game. The art direction is just phenomenal, and I'm really happy that I get to share this game with you guys, because it's pretty awesome. Like, I really suggest, like, if you ever have some time to kill or like want something new to play, try Bastion. Like, you're gonna love it. Like, I promise, it's such a good game. So with that, let's get rolling. Let's continue. So there may be a little bit of overlap because I don't know if it saved when I built the distillery, I think it was.
He comes back, just like I knew he would.
So we may have a little bit of overlap, but I'm sure you guys don't mind. Here we go.
The core hums in his pack.
Yeah, the monument's there's a little overlap, but not a big deal. It's only a couple minutes.
Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next.
Talk the stranger.
The windbags used to be all right. Then the calamity took the floor out from under him.
Okay, I think I made the forge. Yeah, because I want upgrades. Upgrades.
A lot of things need fixing up in this world. And we can start right here.
I can do this on the crippled attacks.
A little Zolwood oil and that blade shines like a light.
So, if you guys haven't been following my Twitter, I did actually get Instagram finally for Miss Mosh Plays. So you can actually follow me on that now, and I'll be able to post more updates. And they, of course, post automatically to my Twitter and my Facebook account for Miss Mosh Plays, which is really easy to keep up with all my videos and everything. I'm going to try the Breaker Barracks again, because I think I can do it this time. I have a bow upgrade, and I'm going to kick this challenge's ass. Like, I have to do this at this point. Like, I did so badly yesterday. Like, I gotta do it. So let's see. Okay, well, that went terribly. Hold on. God damn it. Let's try that again, shall we? Okay. Power shot. Okay, well, that went like ass again. Okay, well, I can't stop it. God damn it. Shots may have been fired, but shots were fired very poorly. Oh god. This is embarrassing. I mean, not really embarrassing. I just, like, really, Emily? Really, Mosh? Like, let's get this straight here. Like, you suck. Alright. Back to the Skyway. If you guys are ever interested in actually, like, playing games with me or, like, talking to other people who like my videos or whatever, I do have a Steam group. I don't actually know how to get a link for it right now. I'll figure that out. But if you guys are interested, I will put the link for the Steam group in the description for this video once I put it up on my YouTube channel. That way, if you guys want, you can, like, do that. You can talk to me, talk to other people who like my videos. And all that fun stuff. I'm sorry, I'm really bad at talking today. But long story short, Steam group, we hang out, play video games. I have a magic butt ton of video games, and there are more on the way because I am really bad at saving my money. Yeah. I just kind of, oh god.
Blasted things hurt like a broken heart.
Oh, that took a while, but whatever. If you're in my stream, someone has just linked the group, the Steam group, in the chat. Thanks, Hibby. Yeah, I like can't talk today. I should have not just fallen off the edge of the world. Like that would have been really nice. Like, good job, me.
He cuts down every stab weed like there's gonna be a prize for it. If there's a core, he figures it ought to be deeper down.
Okay, yeah, let's not get stabbed by the stab weeds because I'll frickin' suck. Break a bunch of
Core stuck
shit.
inside one of those fancy cages.
One of those fancy cages. I love the stranger's voice so much. Like, super relaxing to hear him talk. I really like it. Just fucking break everything. Just fuck everything up with a machete. Just everything. Oh, look, a health potion. Well, that was handy. Also, if you guys see me just like kind of like
Silver
continuously
stuff
looking
lying
over the
around is
side,
downright
I have two
dangerous.
monitors set up, so I've got the stream chat set up over on my secondary monitor. So if anyone like says anything, I can try and respond in a timely fashion, but chances are, knowing me, that's probably not what's gonna happen. I'm probably gonna be like 20 minutes later, be like, "Oh, hi, what's up?"
No
How the
breaking a cage
Oh,
like that,
I'm
but the
dumb.
kid tries anyway.
There's a switch right here.
He throws a switch. Gotta find a way to spring it open. Now, what could possibly go wrong?
Everything could go wrong. That's what.
Quite a bit,
Literally
as it
everything.
turns out.
Well, money is literally
The
falling from
cage
the
starts
sky,
lifting
so
from
that's
the core
nice.
ever so slow.
Yay,
All
money.
kid
Oh,
can
God.
do
Ah,
is
frickle
wait.
frack.
Shipments start falling in.
No! Oh, damn.
Not
That
every
was pretty
score's going
rad.
bad. Some spring to the kid's defense.
All right. Let's
Judging by the
fuck up
movement
these
of the
squirt
cage,
stays,
it's
huh?
gonna take a little while.
And windbags. Oh, God. I'm really bad at dodging. Like, I should not be bad at that, but unfortunately, I am. Okay.
Scumbags don't take kindly to interlopers.
Shit.
Even some gas fellas take his corner. Heard he pop that mean old fork.
Alright, this scumbag needs to die.
At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes. Maybe 30. Hard to tell. Shows up. It ain't all bad, as the kid finds some spices from the motherland, tax free.
Alright, this scumbag needs to fuck off.
One thing's for sure, that cage
oh
is
God.
so heavy.
What the frickle frack just happened? Oh my God, I'm dead.
He's gotta hold out just a little longer.
Okay, hold on. My screen moved. Everything moved. I don't know what happened. where'd the chat go? There it is. Somehow, like, all of my chat windows got made to be, like, exactly the same size and, like, whatever.
It's a troublesome scene, to be sure.
Oh, there we go.
Thank you. 7, give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done.
Yeah, unfortunately for me, I'm still getting killed.
He's got it. Just gotta get to the nearest barge.
That was mildly stressful, and by mildly, I mean very. Let's pick everything off. On the barge we go. That was difficult.
I still remember the look on his face after that one. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Ceylandia. It was good living here for a while. The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started.
Alright, let's build a distillery.
Get some Makes spirits. Time to sample spirits from my personal supply.
Alright, 10 max health, crit chance, carry on, 100%, 93 speed.
Cinder good. Brick stout sure goes down smooth, then stays in your gut like a rock. Kid packs a special surprise in every one of those arrows.
Repeater.
Turns out those old bones still have some spark in them.
Okay, sundown path. Yeah, I don't want to embarrass myself with the machete thingy right now. I'm really bad at that one. So I'm just gonna go get the next core.
Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure though. Somebody gets to the core before
Uh-oh.
The kid.
Well, that's not good. Fucker stole my core.
The floor starts giving way under the lightest step. A single panic squirt could bring the whole place down. Fragments of the old world rain from the sky.
Have time for these.
Stray valuables are lying everywhere. Kid thinks twice about risking his hive for them, though. Well, the path ain't exactly open to visitors no more. Security is all fired up.
Oh no. Really? Are you just gonna keep landing me in the middle of nothing? Okay. That was bullshit game. And you know it.
See, the path was intended for leisurely strolling and such.
For running for your life?
Not so much for noise and tomfoolery. Sky bridges link the path together.
Pretty terrible. Like what the hell?
One of them bridges whips the kid along. Air travel always was an iffy proposition.
Oops. Oh, god damn it. I missed the thing. Kill all these squirts with this fire-breathing turret, like, no big deal.
But Calamity changed everything, even where the wind blows.
Ooh, fam.
Well, if we mastered the winds in the old days, we can do it again. Question is, who else could have taken the core? Well, ain't no survivor stole the thing.
That was really hard. That was upsetting. That shouldn't have been that hard.
Ship live munitions down the path. Find time to find them. He's wise to toss those things plenty far away. Even gas fellas need some shut eye from time to time. They get real cranky.
Not miss this item. Skybridge. Oh my god. It's almost happened again.
In all this toil, kid keeps coming back to an overwhelming question. Who else could have survived the calamity? So he didn't find the core that time, but that ain't about to stop us.
I can't use yet.
What else is there to say?
Okay. Let's go to the Hanging Gardens.
The dead welcome him with open arms. Oof. The calamity took everybody after all. Kids sees it plain, frozen faces all around. He don't much care to see him. Not like this. These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close. Someone who ain't like Mr. Beckley and his kindly wife.
So, I mean, I've never finished this game. Like, I'm almost done.
Like him.
I really hope this game has, like, a happy ending, because I don't know if I can handle a sad ending. I'll probably cry.
He ain't about to stop, no matter what.
Like, this game's really sad. It makes me really sad.
He's got so many questions, after all. The Tundra Brothers didn't make it.
Ah!
They never saw what it was like beyond the walls. Nor did the Bird Boy. Didn't make it. The Jawsons, they didn't make it.
It's upsetting, because these are all, like, people he knew while they were alive, and I'm making him murder them.
Grady Jr., they didn't make it.
I'm kind of terrible.
He survived.
Fully admit, though,
Kid finds proof enough that man ain't from around here. Just think, without that man, we wouldn't be here right now, would we?
I love how the world just, like, pieces together.
Well.
Oh my god.
Kid does what he has to do. And then... what do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this. We have to go. Please.
The survivor agreed to return to the Bastion. That's because I'm amazing.
He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf. No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time. For Zulf, Ceylandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east.
Uh-oh. I think it crashed. Again. me try closing it and opening it again. My bad. Sorry, guys. My God, why won't it close? Okay, so it won't close. Let me. And task. There we go. Okay. Let's open that back up. I'm sorry, guys. I have a small processor and it's not happy at me. I need to get a bigger one. Unfortunately, that's not an option at the moment. Alright, well, hopefully I didn't lose too much.
He's a proper gentleman, that
man. Oh God, thank God.
His name is Zulf.
Okay, so we didn't lose that much.
No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time.
Here we go.
We fought the Ura decades ago, but that was then. Things are different between us now. For Zulf, Ceylandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east.
Yeah, it didn't crash that time.
He was born in the Tazzle terminals. The Ura sent him on a mission of peace to our city, and he's lived here ever since. Kid ain't finished here.
Just kidding. I need to put the thingy in the monument. Yay!
The cores. They remember. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be alright.
Things are gonna be alright is right.
Well, look what we have here.
Memorial. Lost and found.
The lost and found. Here, kid takes fragments of the old world and makes them whole again. All it takes is some fragments, and the Bastion makes it good as new.
Get all of these. Stabson. Bastion bourbon. Okay. Upgrades.
We all lost loved ones in the calamity, he says. I don't know how I'm gonna go on without mine.
Poor Zulf.
I tried to let the kid down gently. This is the Bastion, all right. Except no one else showed up. If you're feeling low, count on the buttery flavor of our own Bastion bourbon.
Cinderbrick Fort or Pith Orchard. I think the orchard. Let's go to the orchard. Let's do this.
No use praying to the gods these days. No time for it either. Folks used to make pilgrimage here to pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone
now. Scrap of land was kind of
hard
to... And
the Orchard Core is long gone, too. Seems Pith ain't much of a watchdog. Pith stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration.
I have to go back because there was... I thought that this wasn't the right way, so I was going to explore. But then it ended up being the right way, so I need to go back so I can explore. I don't want to miss things. Like this adorable plush.
The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god.
I want one. For reals.
Well, no use turning back just yet.
Oh my god. Just rocks. Exploration. I'm an explorer.
Pith Orchard. Place is a dead end in more ways than one.
Just kidding. Apparently that's a dead end! Joke's on me. Bad. Sorry if that made like loud angry noises at you.
He couldn't even save his loyal subjects.
I feel bad like murdering everyone. Even though they're already dead, I still feel bad. It's like, I'm gonna stab this person. Nope, let's not go down there.
Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least.
Ah!
Red Pith lights up like a rodeo. Easy punching through his hide. Kid breaks him to bits. Must have been guarding that shrine.
That's difficult.
So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off? Piv.
Sure, why not? Let's throw a god on there.
Kid decides to press his luck. Well, if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore.
Oh my god.
Kid ain't never seen windbags that quick. Maybe old Pith put a scare in him.
See what played in windowed mode in order to stream it, and I keep accidentally clicking on my taskbar.
Kid ain't found a core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine.
Let's see. Still a dead end. Okay. Now I can build a shrine. And I also made the game a lot harder for myself.
Now we can build a shrine of our own, though I got some alternatives in mind. Zulf doesn't touch the thing. Says the god of commotion is no children's toy.
Yay, I have a tiny pith.
The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys.
But that's freaking adorable. I want one.
We tracked down a couple more cores near the edge of the city.
Okay. Let's go to Cinderbrick Fort.
There's only one way into Cinderbrick Fort. The hard way.
Oh, great. That's my favorite way to do things. Definitely hate doing things the easy way. The worst.
Sure, the city marshals may be gone. But now the fort's crawling with windbags.
Yay, I leveled up. Apparently, that's not land. Apparently.
The calamity was mercy for normal folks. The windbags ain't so lucky. They've been left to freeze, or starve, or face the kid.
Really bad job at like not getting my ass kicked on that one.
Wham! Kid's ready for the windbags this time.
Huh? immediately respawn?
Young and old keep fighting for the fort. Kid can't hardly tell up from down after a while.
God damn it. Alright, well, fuck that noise. Very good noise.
Windbags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal.
Weapon, it's just not my favorite.
Look, good for like spread bags topside. A lot of them wound up here in this very fort. Business underground, like in the old days. Windbags can't use martial supplies. But the kid sure can. Okay. He stashes the marshal's prize. Goes back to something more his style.
Yeah. Much better.
As for the windbags, Cinder Brick gave him enough heat and metal to munch on for a while. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though. So many of those sorry things hold up inside that old fort.
Hello, Leon Unleashed. How are you? Thank you for coming to my stream. Thank you. you don't mind me asking, how did you find me?
Kid's stash of grenades is there for him if things get even worse. The windbags put the kid on notice.
God damn it. He barricure in real life.
It ain't afraid of getting burned. They trap the kid in the middle of the force parade grounds.
Amazing. I really can't say enough how much I love this game. Like, I'm gonna be uploading this up to my YouTube after my stream is over, and I spent a good like 3 or 4 minutes at the beginning of my stream just being like, this game is amazing and everyone needs to play it. Like, this game, like, the art direction is so beautiful, like the level design, the controls are really intuitive. It's just overall like a really well put together game, and I'm really happy that I get to like play it for people.
Kid used to dream of getting a Marshall's badge, but not like this.
Yeah, there's a modifier on that makes the mobs a little tougher.
Sight after all that.
So.
And now
I'm kind of kicking my ass. I think I'm gonna do one more level and then wrap up my stream.
Telling me about his own journey to the city.
Just because I am starving and really need some food.
Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Zulf was a smoking pipe.
But like I said, this stream will be uploaded to my YouTube pretty much as soon as it's over. So it should be up probably in a couple hours.
The marshals so seem like good men, he says.
Not take
they
too
treated
long.
Him with dignity. Zolf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals.
I'm also on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, so it's pretty easy to find me.
Poor kid collapses after just
Oops,
one drag.
I didn't mean to do that. Too late, I did it. Okay, so I guess after I...
The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history.
Super fantastic games. I've got a couple. There's Bastion, mostly... I mean, like, everything about this game is amazing. Like, the story design, I mean, the storytelling, the level design, everything. Another one that's amazing is Last of Us. If you haven't played that, I highly recommend it. The storyline on that, like, I cried so much during that game. It's heart-wrenching and beautiful and just wow. Like, I'm... I can't really say a whole lot other than just, wow, that game's really good. Woo! That was close. Oh my god.
Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie.
You don't play video games? You just watch streams, or...?
He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his.
All right, these friggin' popcorn machines have to go. Do not like popcorn when it's made of squirts.
Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money.
Reflections remain. God damn it. Okay,
what
I'm dead.
Saying? Anyway.
Okay, let's try this again.
Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there.
Yeah, I don't the actually... elements, like, admittedly, I don't watch a whole lot of Let's Players. I got kind of into the game pretty late. But, I do really like Markiplier. He's probably one of my favorites. And I know a Let's Player, Legend Fairy. But I've been streaming, well, like for friends and stuff, like I've been streaming for ever.
He hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too.
I've probably been streaming games for, like, friends and stuff for close to 5 or 6 years, but I've only had my channel and stuff up for about 6 months. I started it up in October, that I don't usually, like, stream my games. I usually just record them solo and put them up on YouTube, but I figured this is a game, like, anyone should be able to watch, so I decided I'd stream it and upload it. That way, like, I can help more people see it, basically.
The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, either.
Wah!
So what did the kid do? Why he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years?
Oh my god.
In the history of Ceylandia, nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls.
Yeah, it's very unique. I really like that. I mean, I've been playing games, like, literally my whole life. So it makes me really happy when I actually find, like, a very unique game that has, like, a mechanic or something that I've never really seen before.
Out there, a kid learned to fend for himself. Learn to build. Learn to break.
Hi, Momsh. Momsh is my mom.
In time, the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody.
He's currently sitting in the living room with me on the other side of the room. I think so. Yep, that is my mom.
One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. He saw nothing where the world used to be.
Pretty much.
The calamity happened just like that.
Holy crap! Holy crap! Sometimes while I'm recording games and stuff, my mom throws things at me to scare me, especially when I'm playing Five Nights at Freddy's. That's like her favorite thing ever to do.
All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back.
Mom, that's rude. I say radical. Oh god, I'm gonna die! Paying too much attention to the chat.
Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him.
Yeah, Five Nights at Freddy's is great, and I'm really excited for Five Nights 4. Oh, holy crap! One down. Oopsies. Oh my god. It's happening again. I have it on my PS4 because it's a free game. I believe it was also made by Supergiant, wasn't it?
Well, it finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaunted safe haven. He and no one else. But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his
Yeah, name. I haven't really, I haven't tried it yet. I've played, like, maybe, like, 5 minutes of it. But I don't really count that as trying it.
Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real. Not me.
Well, I'm fucked. I died. I'm dead. Okay, I'm gonna go back to Bastion. Alright, so I am starving, so I'm gonna go get some food. Thank you guys for stopping into my stream. It really means a lot to me. For those of you guys watching on YouTube, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and definitely share with your friends. Let them know how rad this game is and how much you enjoy watching me play it. So, thanks for watching. Bye, guys!